So as I'm about to tune down the music as I usually do before I start talking, I've got my finger on the mouse. I'm about to click, and all of a sudden I just hear my heater just start kicking on. It's like, oh, God damn it. So I had to go run and turn it off. It's still running right now. You can probably hear it. But it should be shutting off after this cycle. Anyways, hi. What's up? We're going to first stretch in my chair. Because I think I slept weirdly on my left hand. My thumb isn't exactly being that responsive, which is great for when you play video games on the internet in front of people. And we're going to be picking up where we left off last time with Phoenix Wright, where he had just confronted D.Va. Okay. Someone pointed out to me, I think it was Gamer, he PM'd me after last time I streamed. And he said, I think the joke is that her name is Diva-esque, as in she's like a diva. I still want to call her Diva Squeeze. Or Diva Diva Squeeze! God damn it. I still want to call her Diva Squee, or whatever the fuck I used to call her. I don't even remember what I used to call her now. It's gone. Diva Squeeze. And, I guess it's Diva-esque. Her name sucks. I hate her. But basically, we had confronted her, and she has connections to the mafia, and she chased us out. So, we'll have to. Well, actually, she didn't chase us out. Gumshoe showed up, which, how appropriate now that I'm playing this tune, and I completely forgot about his grand rescue. So, we have a court case to do. And this will be the last part of this case. Now, I'm not planning on doing like a huge Phoenix Wright stream tonight. I just want to do enough to wrap this case up, and then I will move on to something else. What that something else is, it probably will be Rune Factory. We'll see how I'm feeling after the fact. That's just enough of me talking. Why don't we get started here? Sorry, Gumshoe. You're dismissed. I bet you'd like to give Diva a squeeze, huh?
You're a real funny guy. You know that? You're real funny.
It's a good thing I took a nap because now my voice isn't warmed up anymore. So I might sound a little weird starting off. And we are right into the thick of it already.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Today will be the final day of this trial. I hope both the prosecution and the defense will be able to present decisive evidence. Very well, Mr. Edgeworth. Your opening statement.
In yesterday's session, the defense presented us with a new theory for this case. He claims that the scene of the crime was, in fact, Studio 2. Today, I will call on people present at Studio 2, trailer that day. From the testimonies, the truth will become clear.
Very well.
Edward seems a bit on edge today. Wow. Nice joke. That inner monologue, pun was so lit, it got everybody fired up in the courtroom.
You may call your first witness, Mr. Edgeworth.
The prosecution calls Miss Divas. Miss Divas Squeak.
God damn it.
Calls Miss Divas Squeeze to the stand. Miss Divas Squeeze is a producer who was present at the Studio 2 trailer that day.
She's smoking in the courtroom. Is that legal?
Will the witness state her name and occupation?
Divasquez, I'm producer for Global Studios.
On the day of the murder, you were in the trailer? Trailer? Ooh. Get a little wild with that voice, eh? In Studio 2.
As everyone here knows, yes? I dislike needless banter. If you must pontificate, do it when I'm not here.
Very well, Mr. Squeeze. Please give the court your testimony concerning the day of the murder.
Nick, I know she did it. Make her pay.
Right. If she's guilty, I'll catch her with her pants down, so to speak. Yeah, maybe it was legal in the 50s. Pretty sure this isn't the 50s no mo.
I entered the trail a little before noon. The meeting began at 12 o'clock sharp. It ended at 4 o'clock. There was to be a rehearsal afterwards, so I went to Studio One. I was fatigued, so I had Sal take me. At 2:30, we took a 15-minute break in the meeting. Sal and I ate T-bone steaks on the table in front of the trailer. We found Hammer's body later, when we all went to Studio One. That is all.
I have a question about one part of your testimony. You were fatigued, so you had Sal take you?
The van. There's a van at Studio 2. I had them take me in that. I thought it might be risky to walk, what with that monkey's head toppling over.
Great.
I see. Very well, Mr. Wright, your cross-examination.
This is the final battle, Nick. Let's do it.
Yeah. Let's do it.
By yourself?
Yes.
And you didn't stop in at the employee area?
No.
Are you always this terse?
Yes.
Oh dear. I always press the button when it's too damn early. Did no one leave during the meeting?
No one.
Come on, let's talk a bit more about that.
The witness did not come here to engage in a conversation. Stop interrupting.
Ooh, you got a rolling R there.
Stop interrupting the testimony.
The same could be said to you, Mr. Edgeworth. And please, stop banging on your little desk. It hurts my ears. Do not bang on your little desk.
And what exactly was that?
I've forgotten.
Maybe you could try remembering?
No.
The meeting ended at 4 o'clock, and the rehearsal was scheduled for 5 o'clock. I would think it was between those times.
You would think? Come on, all you did was state the obvious, Edgeworth. Hold on. You had Sal take you? What does that mean?
It means what I just said. I had Sal take me in the Studio 2 van.
Oh, alright. And what were you doing during that time?
Don't hit your desk. It irritates me.
Yeah, that's still right. Oops.
It was a 15-minute break.
That's pretty funny. Do you have someone who can verify this?
Sal.
No, I mean someone else?
One person is enough.
She committed murder during that break. She wouldn't have had time to eat a T-bone steak. That's some evidence that proves she didn't eat that steak.
Well, Nick, find anything?
Kinda wish she'd said a bit, little more.
It's hard, I think she's pretty used to being the boss. But I'm sure you'll find some kind of contradiction in what she said, somewhere.
Let's take a look. As the evidence.
I was in the employee area. I don't recall there being any bones on the plates in the Studio 2, but I don't think I have any evidence of that.
So that might just be conjecture.
But Zivan.
I would think that how would it have been possible to use the van if the road was blocked anyways? Because the monkey head was in the way. So wait. It ended at 4 o'clock. The monkey head would have fallen over by then.
Jeez.
It just sounds so weird to me. Monkey head fell over. Blocked the path to the scene of the crime between 2:15 and 4. Oh, wait. It got out of the way at 4. Fuck. Wait a minute. It ended at 4. Oh, what is it with these exact timetables? Jeez. Here, let me just present this photo. Nah, that's not gonna help. At all. I have to prove you didn't eat the steaks, huh? Hmm. This was retrieved from the employee area. It's like, why didn't we take pictures of the plates in the Studio 2 area? I don't remember there being bones? Maybe there was? It's just details. This woman probably sounds like Miss Oldbag by now with how much she smokes. Nah, I could believe it. Oh man, this one's dragging on one leg. 2 o'clock p.m. Huh. We could insinuate that she was the person in the suit at 2 o'clock, but that doesn't seem very decisive to me. Hmm. When in doubt, attorney badge out. Oh man, this one's rough.
Hold it!
Jeez. Hmm. At 2:30, we took a 15-minute break in the meeting. Was it at 2:30? I know something contradicts that. Ugh. This is painful. The worst part of it is, if it's like something really obvious, and it's staring me right in the face, like it's gonna take a minute for it to click. Time of death at 2:30. Damn. The only thing I can really think of is this photo. Which would have meant that... Huh. So whoever was in this suit headed towards Studio 2 at 2 o'clock, meaning... Because based on Cody's photo, he was standing in front of the place, but the head would have fallen after that. So either it's her in the suit, or it's someone else in the suit, and they weren't the only two people there. I don't know. I feel like I'm really stretching here. Damn. After the meeting in the trailer. Maybe I just gotta read between the lines a bit. Stupid desk hitting thing. They're insinuating that they want me to present something to contradict this statement right here. Wait, didn't Sal before say that he couldn't eat the steaks or something? I can't remember. It's like something in his testimony had something to do with the fact that he couldn't eat the steaks. But then I think later it was revealed that he did? God, all this shit around steak. I want steak. Does anybody remember?
Does anybody remember the T-bone steak? Oh.
This is rough. Okay, it wants me to present something here, so I should probably just fuss my way through it. Yeah, he said he couldn't eat steak when, in fact, he did eat steak. I mean, shit. Alright, let's just go for it. Objection! Oh, okay, that was correct. It'll make sense once they go through the dialogue, but man, it's really not hitting me right now. As I thought. You claim you ate a T-bone steak. But I say you did not.
What's this now, Mr. Wright?
Look at this.
It's a plate?
This plate was on the table in the employee room. As you can see, a large bone has been left behind.
Mr. Wright, need I remind you it was a T-bone steak?
Exactly my point. Remember, if you will. Are they going to say the fact that the bone doesn't look like a T-bone? Miss Fasqueeze and Mr. Manella ate at a table outside the trailer. Yeah, see, I'm looking at the plates. Yet there were no bones. Okay! So they just... Man, they were really hoping that I remembered that. Because I swear I remembered that, but I wasn't really confident. The plates were bare. Look at her face. Miss Fasqueeze. Tell me, how could a person eat a T-bone steak and not leave the bone? I don't know, maybe the bitch threw it over the wall. I think I know how. You ate the bone too? You ate a boneless steak? You ate the bone too? I want to say that so hard. Oh man, I want to say it so badly. But you didn't eat the steak, clearly. You didn't eat any steak during that break. You took your steak and threw it somewhere, like that incinerator. But why? Oh, okay. That's a bit of a stretch. The fuck?
I see! And what was Mr. Squeeze doing a break?
Isn't it obvious, Your Honor? Picking on Salmonell, meeting the Steel Samurai. Well, clearly, picking on Salmonella seems like the red herring in this. She was meeting with the Steel Samurai.
Order! Are you saying?
Yes, Your Honor. As Miss Fasqueeze left the trailer to eat her steak, She ran into the steel samurai, and then you did it. You killed him with your own hands.
Mr. Wright! Isn't that a little presumptuous?
What kind of stunt are you trying to pull, Wright?
Let him claim what he wants.
You say I did it?
Yes.
Fascinating. And here I was worrying that today would be as boring as all the rest. Very well. Let us have a battle of wits, you and I.
Any day of a squeeze.
Good luck, Nick.
Let's see. What was that murder weapon again? Oh yes, the samurai spear.
Yes?
I am, as you can see, a woman of petite stature. How could I possibly use that spear as a weapon?
I mean, she could have gotten one of her thugs to do it that just suddenly showed up out of nowhere, but... I'm gonna say you couldn't. I think you would have a great deal of difficulty using that as a weapon. Pretty much anyone would.
Huh. You see?
Yes. However, that has no bearing on this case.
Meaning?
The samurai spear was not the murder weapon.
Uh-huh. I wondered.
What is the meaning of this? A spear is found lying next to the victim's body?
I have proof, Your Honor. I can prove that the samurai spear was not used as the murder weapon.
Blech.
There was a hair in my mouth.
Could it have been this with the fence? Or could it have been the fact that the photo had the steel samurai with the spear at 2 o'clock? I might go. Well, there's the spear itself as well. Break in the shaft has been mended with duct tape. I mean, the spear must be flimsy, so... It's either that, or it's the spear itself. I'm gonna say it's the spear. I present my proof, the so-called murder weapon. Yeah, I'm sure there'd be blood on the spear too, but I think it's a bit more... it's a little less obvious than that.
But then that is the murder weapon.
Not so fast. Remember that the spear broke during the morning action scene run-through? But someone fixed the spear. It was the security lady. She fixed it with duct tape. There's another hair in my mouth and I can't get it.
Get it. Yeah. Nah.
Now tell me, how is it possible for someone to stab a man who is wearing a thick costume with this through the chest?
Harder, harder!
Oh, I finally got the hair.
Mr. Wright, what are you driving at? Think about what you...
Silence. I am the one testifying here, and I will be heard. Are you quite sane?
Are you even aware of what you're saying? Oh, she's saying that. Whoops.
If the samurai spear was not the murder weapon, then pray tell what was. How was Hammer killed?
Well, Mr. Wright, can you tell us what weapon was used to kill Mr. Hammer?
I can tell you... Probably. Would I make a claim like that if I couldn't tell you what the weapon was?
I'm afraid your confidence could sometimes be unfounded, Mr. Wright. Very well. Let's see this murder weapon then.
I bet it's the fence. It was the fence. Had to have been.
Unless it was the van. Meep meep.
Look at this photo. Oh no. Oh no.
Oh, what is this? Well, it's Jack Hammer standing at the top of the stairs!
It's the attorney badge!
Order! Order! If I cannot have order, this trial will be suspended!
Although, you can't because it's the last day, but whatever.
Mr. Wright? What is this all about?
This photograph is from 5 years ago. There was an unfortunate accident at Global Studios.
This is a photo of that very accident. Not a word of this was leaked to the outside. It was a close-kept secret at the studios. What does this have to do with the current case? Mr. Edgeworth, you still can't see it? See the fallen man in this photo? See how the fence post pierced him through the chest?
What are you saying?
Yes. What happened 5 years ago? Has happened again. Oh shit.
Mr. Wright, continue!
It's 2:30 p.m. on the day of the murder. Miss Diva Squeeze meets Jack Hammer outside the Studio 2 trailer. Then she did it. She pushed Mr. Hammer off the stairs onto the fence. Just like Mr. Hammer had himself done 5 years ago. Though whether she did it on purpose or by accident, I cannot say.
In other words, the victim, Mr. Hammer, he died in the same way that he caused another man to die. 5 years ago.
Precisely. Ironic, isn't it?
Oh, very creative, Mr. Wright. I could use a man like you on my script writing staff.
You deny that is what I say is true? Ooh, I read that very weirdly.
Mr. Wright, let's say, for the sake of argument, that Hammer died at the trailer, as you say. Yet the body was found at Studio One, was it not? And in the evil magistrate's costume, no less. Are you then claiming that I carried the body to Studio One and returned to the trailer all in the space of a 15-minute break? How could I have disposed of the body?
The break in the meeting of the trailer lasted 15 minutes from 2:30 to 2:45. Could Jack Hammer have been pushed off the stairs to his death, then carried to Studio One and placed inside his costume? There wasn't enough time.
Indeed. Well, Mr. Wright, how could you have dealt with the body?
Probably use the van, although the road would have been blocked, so... Ooh, that's actually tough. I bet one of these is a dead-end choice. She probably got Salmonella to help her out, but... I mean... Could he, in theory, drag that thing all the way over there by himself? She couldn't have used the van, I would think. 2:30 to 2:45. The statue fell at 2:15. Unless they're bullshitting me and saying that the break time was not actually at 2:30 and it was at 2 or something stupid like that. Oof. This is tough. Okay. I'm going to go with my first choice here and say that she couldn't do it and she had someone help her. Well, I guess she had another way would mean that too. You know what? Fuck it. What if she had another way to carry the body other than with her own hands?
For instance?
Actually, for that matter, there was no need for her to do the deed in 15 minutes. Oh, you know what? She could have just dumped it in the back of the van and just left it there until after the meeting. Just thought of that. And there was a way for you to carry that body.
Interesting. Let's hear it then.
Mr. Wright, please show us how she carried the body.
With the van, you know, the van.
Yeah, death smash.
Miss Vesqueeze, you carried the body to Studio One, and you used the studio van to do it. Recall your testimony.
There was to be a rehearsal afterwards, so we went to Studio One. I was fatigued, so I had Sal take me. There was a van there, right? I had Sal drive me.
You used the van to carry the body to Studio One. Then, before everyone else got there, you put the body into the magistrate costume. Oh my god, I had a stroke.
Hold on, right. Don't forget it was Salmonella that drove the van. Are you suggesting that Mr. Manella was a conspirator? That's a tough call, actually.
He seemed really interested in his stake, though. But this would have all been happening right in front of him. Oh, maybe he ate it inside the trailer. I'm gonna say no. Of course he wasn't.
So, without Mr. Manella noticing anything, she put the body in the van, then managed to put the body into the costume? Are you seriously suggesting that it's possible? Oh, okay.
I mean, given the benefit of the doubt, I was kidding to lighten up the proceedings. I'm gonna get a penalty for that.
Lighten? You can't lighten up a murder.
Mr. Wright, the court requests you for rain from
making claims and jest.
Yes, Your Honor. Of course.
I wanted to give Manella a chance, but yeah, he probably helped her. Of course, Salmonella had to have been a conspirator.
The body had to be placed in the van and put into the costume.
I mean, she has thugs.
So, you know, it's not completely out of the bounds of reality. There's no way Miss Visqueeze could have done that alone. Also, don't forget that they had to dispose of the Steel Samurai costume. They had to, because it was covered in Mr. Hammer's blood. They probably burned it in that small incinerator.
Let me just yawn in the middle of my,
declaration. Well, Miss Visqueeze, shall I continue?
No need. You're smarter than you look, Mr. Wright. Fünf. I lose. You win. It was fun.
I win? What, is it over? That quick? So, what happens next? Don't question mark me. Don't you have anything to say?
What would you like me to say?
Huh? I lost? Something like that?
I just said that.
Well, wait, so you mean... Diva Squeeze, so it was you! You killed Jack Hammer!
Okay.
Who can say?
Huh?
Are you sure I did? Mr. Wright, we just engaged in a battle of wits, and the result of that battle, you proved the possibility that I murdered Hammer.
Hammer. Right.
But that is only a possibility. Proof is another thing altogether. You lack decisive proof, Mr. Wright.
What?
Order! Mr. Edgeworth, your thoughts?
Of course, it's as the witness says. And he grabbed onto that string. Certainly, it does seem very likely she did it, but there's no proof. Edgeworth isn't sure.
Well, I came here as a witness today. If you have no more questions, I'll be leaving.
Ugh, what do I do now? Testify again, I would say, yeah. Well, shit. What is a testimony gonna do? I'm gonna say testify again. I'd like you to testify again. He doesn't sound very confident about that.
Testify again?
No one to give up, Mr. Wright. Think about it. Even if I were to testify again, what's the point? I can only say what I said before, the truth, Mr. Wright. I've already said all there is to say. What would happen if I said it again? Fuck.
You'd ask the same questions, get the same...
Oh, wow, that was like mix of the squeeze and... Edgeworth, whoops!
You'd ask the same questions, get the same answers. A waste of time.
Damn. Damn! To come so far only to fail. Oh. People are ay-ay-ay-ing. It must have been the correct choice.
As it seems, there are no further questions. I would like to end the cross-examination of the witness, Lucifer Squeeze.
Objection! Uh-oh.
Yes, Mr. Edgeworth?
I was hoping to come up with a question while I was objecting, Your Honor. I didn't.
Oh. I see. Very well.
Your Honor, I request that the witness testify again.
You are the prosecutor, are you not? Why are you badgering me? I am your witness.
I just want to hear your testimony again.
Does this make any sense to you, Your Honor? I don't see that we have anything to gain by repeating the last several minutes.
Mr. Edgeworth, I do see little point in making Miss Fusquiz repeat herself. What exactly do you want to hear to testify about?
Well, yes, Indeed, verily I say, ergo. I want to hear about what happened after they found the body.
After they found the body? Very well. The witness will testify to the court concerning this matter.
Oof. Nick! What did Edgeworth?
Who knows? He probably realized she did it too.
But... Wasn't he the one that said he always gets a guilty verdict? After all that?
Edgeworth.
Oh shit, what's up, Gilgrim? How you doing, man? I've seen you forever.
It's good to have you. Oh, yeah, did you hear that snapping? Yeah, that's the sound of sleeping on your arms incorrectly.
I was with Sal and Oldbag, the security lady, when we found the body. The assistant was there too, only Paris was absent. I immediately called the police, then Paris showed up. The security lady, Oldbag, was quite agitated, pointing at Paris saying he did it. I asked to be left out of the proceedings. I went back to the trailer to get my script and direction notes. Then I went home.
I see no issues related by this testimony. Mr. Wright, your cross-examination.
Okay, Nick, we're close. Real close. She may be acting tough now, but if you put her on the spot, she's sure to falter. Find the key you need and twist the truth out of her, Nick.
You just jam it right into her twist.
Right. Press. Everything. What time was that?
People told me it's 5 o'clock for the rehearsal, so I'd say it was then.
When exactly did you and Mr. Manella arrive at the studio?
About 10 minutes before. I wasn't stuffing any bodies into costumes, mind you.
Where were the other employees when you got to the studio?
They weren't there yet.
Well? Then you could have put Hammer in that costume with Salmonella's help.
Oh? What did I just say? Did I not just say I wasn't stuffing anybody's into any costumes? You should try to listen to what people are saying, boy.
Boy?
The witness will continue her testimony.
Mr. Powers was taking a nap, correct?
So he says.
Did no one go to call him?
Remember.
Remember what?
There was a dead body lying in front of us, yet you expect me to be calm?
You certainly seem calm enough when I accuse you of murder. Wait a second. Wouldn't that be the other way around?
The other way around?
You discovered a murdered body and one person was missing, right? Wouldn't you normally go looking for the missing person?
I have to agree with the defense on this one. Well, Miss Fusquiz?
Logically speaking, perhaps. But no one there was thinking very logically, I assure you. Also, Without his steel samurai costume, Paris doesn't really stand out. We often left him on the bus when shooting at the location. No one noticed he was missing.
Poor Powers.
Well, I suppose it explains that. I will make it to the stroke.
What was everyone else doing at that time?
No one said a thing. It was silent, completely silent. So we stood there until Palos arrived. Finally arrived at the scene. Sorry I'm late. Then silence. Dead silence. Silent.
Hey Nick. Why is everyone so quiet? Someone should do something to lighten things up.
Old bag, the security lady. Why did the security lady think Powers had done it?
She said because she saw him going toward the studio.
Right, the steel samurai. Man, we're pressing everything hard. Did the detective arrest Mr. Powers based solely on the security lady's word?
Perhaps not. She seems to have also given the detective that photograph. Of course, I heard all this after the fact.
A photograph, meaning the one taken by the security camera.
She's not known for exhibiting the best sense of judgment when it comes to hammer.
I don't think there's anything in there I can use. Oh, we're looping. Oh, I asked to be left out of the proceedings, that's the last one. You asked to be left out?
Yes. It seems that everyone else was questioned. And I'm really not fond of that sort of thing.
But you can't just decide who the police will and won't question.
Thankfully, the studio thinks otherwise. They were nice enough to understand that since we are in a meeting, there is no way we could have been involved. Thus, they covered for us.
Covered for you? Or covered it up for you? There must have been a lot riding on it with all those bigwigs at the meeting. I'm sure her professionals helped convince everyone they didn't require questioning. The script in your direction notes.
Yes, they're quite valuable. It wouldn't do to have them stolen.
No, I guess not. Wait a second. I thought you came to Studio One for a rehearsal. Why didn't you bring your script and notes?
Well, I was under the impression that we wouldn't be able to rehearse anything.
Why?
There was a murder, after all. Who could think of rehearsing after that?
Oh yeah, I guess. Wait a minute. She didn't bring her script with her because there was a murder. Okay, whatever.
Very well, Mr. Squeeze, please continue.
Oh. Your Honor. I have an objection to the witness's last statement. Huh? Think. Miss Fesquay says she didn't bring the script because there were dead bodies over the house, so... See, that's exactly what I was thinking. Don't you see what that means? She would have had to know about the murder before going to Studio One. Whoops.
Order! Mr. Edgeworth! What you have just said is a reasonable observation. However, I find it hard to understand why the prosecution would make such a move. Already thinking of a career change to defense.
I appreciate the concern, Your Honor. I will stand by my statement, however, regardless of how the court sees my role here.
Now, Miss Fesquise, do you have an explanation? I can't believe Edwards is helping me.
So the prosecution is in cahoots with the defense? What kind of court is this?
It's kangaroo court.
No matter. I think you misunderstood me. I had a perfectly good reason to believe there would be no rehearsal.
Very well. The witness will change her testimony to reflect this reason.
I knew that Hammer was injured and couldn't do any action scenes, so I left them behind.
Getting heated up. The music's not changing. How did you know about the injury?
How did I know?
Sal. He told me.
Sal, the director? But neither of them... Wait, I don't think either of them were at the studio when they were rehearsing in the morning, were they?
You have to find something to peg this on her here, or everything we've done till now will have been wasted. I believe in you, Nick. Go get him.
That just seems wrong.
Oh, whoops.
Back to the trailer to get my script and direction notes. Didn't we find the script in Studio One, though? Hold on a second. I thought we found her script for her. Oh, God. What the fuck do I even have? Went back to the Wait a minute. Went back to the trailer. Well, the monkey head would have been moved by then. Oh boy. Huh. Hold on a second. Could it be the fact that this person in the suit is imitating the injured Will Powers, dragging his way up to Studio 2? Could that be the reason how she found out? I think that might be it. It seems like a huge stretch, though. Ah, damn. Oh, I accidentally presented it! I didn't mean to present that just now. I was going to back out and press her again on that. I did present the photo, didn't I? Oh, that's hilarious. Talk about a miracle. I guess. I mean, I was going to do it anyways, but... Oops. When he said objection, I, like, jumped in my chair. I was like, whoa. Slow down, Phoenix. You knew that Hammer was injured. Don't you think that's a little funny? I mean, it was the Steel Samurai who was injured. It was Will Powers. Oh, it wasn't the Steel Samurai who was injured. It was Will Powers. What? Yeah, there you go.
Mr. Wright, explain yourself!
Yes, Mr. Hammer is dragging his leg in this photo. But that's because he was pretending to be Mr. Powers.
Pretending.
I guess the court has already accepted that it was Hammer in the suit? Alright, whatever.
Pretending.
One person was injured in the run-through that morning. That person was Mr. Powers, not Mr. Hammer. Now, why did you think it was Mr. Hammer who was injured? Wait, am I reading this right? I feel like I just read that line wrong. I'm so confused right now. Wait, did she say that Will was injured or that Hammer was injured? Somebody hopefully caught that in the chat. I'm gonna sip on this beer. Like, my head is just going all over the place right now. Like, I can't remember what I just read less than 20 seconds ago. Less than 5 seconds ago. Okay. Relax, we can hammer out the details later. I swear to God. Alright then, well. They'll piece it together.
I already said it was Sal who told me. That's right. He must have gotten it wrong.
I think not. Mr. Manila was at the run-through that morning. He would have known it was Mr. Powers who was injured. He saw it happen. Why would he tell you the wrong person? Miss Pasquise, if this happened earlier where she mentioned it was Hammer, it completely went over my head during the testimony. I must have just completely missed that. You saw Hammer limping. Yeah, that seems about right. Actually, you didn't hear anything from Mr. Manila. You saw Mr. Hammer limping with your own eyes.
Yes, but wasn't it Mr. Powers who was injured?
Judge is a little slow. Yes, Mr. Manila's first name is, in fact, Sam. Or no, actually, it's Sal, not Sam. I read Sam and I was like, yes, it is Sam! Except when it's not. Which is all the time. Yes, but remember, Mr. Hammer was dragging his leg, too. He was pretending to be Mr. Powers. And when was he doing this? Well, it would have been after he put on the Steel Samurai costume and went to Studio 2 where he was murdered. Exactly. Dush! Miss Vasquise, you met him, didn't you? You saw the Steel Samurai limping. And Mr. Hammer was in that Steel Samurai suit. That's why you were confused. That's why you thought it was Mr. Hammer who had been injured that morning. Ruh-roh. Sal Manila, is he a cook? No, he's a director. Oh, thank God. I think that would have been the icing on the cake if Sal Manila was, like, the cook instead of the director.
Order! Order! I will have order!
Witness, can you refute this claim?
Don't think so. Yeah, let's see you sneak out of this one for squeeze.
Very well. I have a question for you.
Ugh. Why are the real killers always so persistent?
Why in the world would I want Mr. Hammer dead? Yes, he'd fallen at hard times, but here he was a star. I had nothing to gain from his death. Nothing.
Yes, you would need a motive.
Uh-oh.
Why would she have killed the victim? If there is a reason, it is unclear to this court. Has the defense have anything to say on the matter? In other words, can you prove she had a motive?
You know, in a backwards-ass world, what if Hammer got in the suit to pretend he was Will Powers so that he could go up to Diva Squeeze to try to murder her because she had rap on him 5 years ago to get out of her blackmail, and then frame it on Will Powers, but it just so happened that she happened to knock him into the fence and kill him, and then she disposed of the body in the van with Sal? I have no idea. That seems like a huge stretch. First of all, I have to get past this decision here. Can you prove she had a motive? I would say the photo is what that is. I don't know. I mean, she had dirt on him for sure. So maybe, or maybe he got dirt on her. She was trying to silence him. I'm curious to see what would happen if I said no, I can't prove she had a motive. Of course I can't prove it. Nick, no! See, you can't prove it, now would be admitting defeat! She'll get away! But what proof could I possibly have? I don't care if it's impossible, you still have to fight this one! That's funny as hell. It's just another fake-out choice. I wanted to see what would happen, that's... It was worth it.
Yes, Boogie.
Hi. Oh, man. I didn't mute my microphone in time. That one kind of snuck up on me. Okay. I have proof and I'll show it to you. I present to the court evidence as to Miss Vasquez's motive in this murder. I mean, I would assume it's the 5-year-old photo. This is my proof.
This is the photo from before.
This photo reveals the motive in this murder. I'm right, aren't I, Mr. Squeeze? Five years ago, Mr. Hammer was at the height of his fame. With Davis Squeeze's help, a terrible accident was swept under the carpet. Ladies and gentlemen, the case currently up for trial. It began on that day, 5 years ago. Ironically enough, that accident precipitated. Yeah, that's right. Mr. Hammer's fall. His fall from stardom. His guilt weighed him down, no doubt. However, you, Diva Squeeze, used Mr. Hammer. You made him work for you for petty change. Bringing us to the present day, and Mr. Hammer's last role as the evil magistrate. Yes, undoubtedly it was a constant source of shame for the ex-star.
One moment, Mr. Wright. We are talking about motives here, yet you have already talked about Mr. Hammer. It almost seems as if it was Mr. Hammer who had killed Diva Squeeze, not the other way around. What motive would Miss the Squeeze have?
Yes, that's right. According to what you say, I would have had no reason to kill Hammer. He's a good source of income for me. And I never get rid of useful men. It's a policy of mine.
Mr. Wright, please explain Mr. Visqueeze's motive for murder.
Well, that's interesting. It seems like what I said earlier was half right, or I don't know. I'm gonna say she had no motive. I think it was just a heat of the moment thing. Like it was self-defense. She had no motive, Your Honor.
What's that now?
It was Mr. Hammer who was out for blood. Oh, no shit! I was right. All Miss Visqueeze did was push him off the stairs in self-defense.
What's that now?
It's simple. Mr. Hammer was intending to kill Miss Visqueeze.
What?
Your Honor. Jack Hammer drugged Mr. Powers with sleeping pills. Jack Hammer snuck into the dressing room and stole the Steel Samurai costume. Jack Hammer wore the costume to fool the security lady into thinking he was Powers. Then Jack Hammer made his way to the trailer. And for what purpose, you ask? To kill Diva Squeeze, who had so cruelly taken advantage of him all those years. Oh, damn, she broke her thingy. I hope you brought another one. So, you did do it, didn't you? She's smiling. Ugh, that's creepy.
Yes, I am guilty. It was me.
Someone call an ambulance. There's blood everywhere. We're too late. Ah, Miss Visqueeze. What happened here? Manuel fell from the trailer stairs. Oh, this is the 5 years ago thing. Manuel fell from the trailer stairs.
Manuel!
Miss Visqueeze tried to remain calm.
No! How could this...
It was an accident. Mr. Hammer was doing an action scene and...
No! Manuel! Don't touch him, Miss Visqueeze!
No!
Please don't die. Please, Manuel. My love.
Maybe she is Spanish. Vasquez.
Congratulations, Mr. Wright. I lose. Again.
He looks peaceful. It's creepy. Damn.
Damn, son.
Mr. Redworth, where's Diva Squeeze?
In the waiting lobby, Your Honor. As calm and collected as ever.
I see. Mr. Wright,
Yes, Your Honor.
It appears you have brought about yet another miracle.
I thank you, Your Honor. I think not, Your Honor. Will Powers was innocent. That he should be found is only natural. That he should be found so is only natural, not a miracle.
Yes, yes, you're right. Very well. This court finds the defendant, Mr. Will Powers.
Not guilty.
That is all. The court is adjourned.
I don't know what to say. Thank you so much.
I'm just glad you're okay.
Yes, but it's sad. I know now that Mr. Hammer stole my costume. It's bad enough that he wanted to kill Miss Fasquise, but to think that he tried to frame me for the murder, it makes me sad. Tell me why, Mr. Wright. Huh? Tell me. Why did Mr. Hammer want to blame me?
Well, this is what I think. Mr. Hammer wanted to put the blame on you because... I would assume it has to do with the scrapbook. Because he was the hero, and Hammer was not anymore. What's there of this thing? There you are.
Dig that!
It's because you were the Steel Samurai.
Because I was a Steel Samurai?
Mr. Hammer was a big star once. He was reduced to acting in a kid's show, and as the villain to boot. The kids loved the Steel Samurai. I would want to be the villain, that'd be fun as hell. And so, he hated you.
I think I understand. He could have just told me. I would have changed places with him any time.
I think you're missing the point.
Yeah, thank you. I'm just glad it's all over.
So am I. So am I.
Congratulations, WP!
Oh! Thanks to you, I'll be able to don the Steel Samurai outfit once more. I can't wait to get back into that sweaty costume and...
Uh-oh. Somebody better let him know.
Is something wrong?
No, of course not. Ah! Nick! Edgeworth!
Oh. Hello. You're looking like a Glamigus. Say something, right? I'm not good at small talk. Huh? What? That was too bad, Edgeworth. You don't waste any time, Glaute, do you? No, I really want to thank you. The squeeze would have gotten away if you hadn't stepped in.
Ah, pleased to meet you. I'm Powers.
Edgeworth. I'm a big fan of your work, Mr. Powers.
Liar.
Right. I must say, I hadn't expected to meet you again after all these years.
Meet again?
However, in retrospect, it would have been better had we not met. Thanks to you, I am saddled with unnecessary... feelings. Unnecessary feelings? Yes, unease and uncertainty. Aren't those kind of necessary? They only serve to get in my way. You listen to me, Phoenix Wright. Don't ever show your face in front of me again. That's what I came here to tell you. Oh. Nice to see you again, too.
Mr. Wright? Is this guy your friend?
What? Friends? As if. They're rivals. Rivals, right, Nick?
For now we are, I guess.
Huh? Why do I get the feeling I'm missing something? Come on, Nick. Tell me. What's the deal with you and Edgeworth?
Backstory time.
Oh, never mind.
What?
And so the curtain closes on another trial. I caused quite a stir by revealing that accident from 5 years ago. It was the talk of the town.
1 second.
think this ladder's starting to go.
Alrighty.
Thankfully, Global Studios rethought its programming change. They went back to making kids shows again.
Hooray!
Oh no.
Nick! This is it! The new show starts today! You're gonna watch it with me, right?
I'll admit, I was kind of surprised. I didn't think they'd seriously go through with it.
You have to buy trading cards too, okay? We have to trade with Cody and that assistant.
Fine, fine, I'll do it.
Isn't it great that WP gets to play the lead again? I wonder if they'll show his real face this time.
I don't know. I don't think the world is ready for the real Will Powers. That's the end, isn't it? Oh, damn. Well, that's about 1 hour and 10 minutes of a stream. And then we have one more trial. Turnabout goodbyes. I did promise that I would move on after this, mostly just because I don't want to leave anything hanging right now. At least we wrap this up, so it's a little shorter. So I could do... Here's what I'll do. Let me put this here and then get some music going. I'm considering Rune Factory. I mean, I've got a couple of hours of streaming in me right now. Considering it's early on in the week. I wanted to talk about something real quick since I have you guys here and before I switch. I know most of you who are in the Discord have heard this already, but I do want to bring up the fact that Twitch has changed their partnership requirements. So basically, they've removed the strict number of concurrent viewers. That's the big one. Meaning that if a channel continuously grows and has people coming back over the course of a period of time, they'll consider you for partnership. Now, funny that this had to happen after last summer when my channel growth was explosive. What I mean to do now is start really pushing channel growth again. I forgot where I was going with this. I kind of just wanted to lightly bring it up. I'll go into this more into detail in the near future, but there are going to be some changes. Now, when I say that... Words. Rune Factory would be a good chill stream for Monday night. One of the things that I do plan on doing is going back to a more regular broadcasting schedule, meaning that certain days of the week have certain genres or games, or that way people who tune in for a certain game can know to come back on certain days of the week. However, what this means is that we would in theory be waiting until, you know, next Monday for another Rune Factory stream or whatever. It will keep things bouncing around for people who do come back regularly. We do have people who come back here pretty frequently, no matter what game I'm playing, which is nice. And I really like that. But there are people out there who do just want to tune in for one specific game, and that's understandable. Or like a specific genre, and I understand. I totally do. So just to kind of summarize what my plans are, at least one of them. Monday night, in my head right now, feels like it's a good night to have chill, relaxed games, maybe RPGs, simulators, text-based games like this, mostly because Monday night is kind of a, you know, the weekend has just ended. Everybody's trying to pick up their energy for the week again. You know, something high energy probably wouldn't be as suited for Monday as, let's say, something like Friday would be better for higher octane, higher adrenaline type stuff, but I can go into that into detail later on. I just wanted to kind of let the people here know who are here for Phoenix Wright specifically. Phoenix Wright's going to be bouncing around a little bit just because it's a bit of a longer game, and plus we're reaching the end, so I do want to try to wrap it up. I might do a Phoenix Wright stream on Saturday, but don't hold me to it. We'll see how this week goes. I might do it on Wednesday.
Wednesday and Saturday to me feel like they should be good mixed days. So, like, if I have something going on and I want to continue making progress, I can do it on Wednesday and Saturday. See, if I spend too much time talking about it, I'm just going to keep thinking about it. So, for the time being, until I get a more permanent schedule in place, just keep an eye on Twitter, because I always announce my streams. And if you're here for Phoenix Wright, just come check the Twitter. Or just check at 8 o'clock some night, or leave a follow. That way you get an email notification. Actually, I think you might have to turn it on manually, if I remember correctly. But anywho, I'm going to cut the stream to separate the video for the YouTube channel, and when I come back, we'll do some Rune Factory for a few hours. Some audience interactive games would be nice. I agree. We did Choice Chamber a while back, and I did that about as much as I could. I mean, we didn't like 100% the game or anything, but we did beat the game several times. So, if there were more games out there that did that, that would be great. But Choice Chamber, I mean, it could make a return someday, but probably not anytime soon. If you happen to think of any that have audience participation, let me know either in the Discord channel or you can leave me a message on Twitch or you can tweet me. My email is also here on the channel. So, but basically, we're going to try to work together to get channel growth going again. You know how close I was to saying we're going to make this channel great again? I was this close to saying it, and I had to catch myself. So anyways, let me go ahead and take this offline, and I'll be gone for a few minutes, and when I come back, we'll do Rune Factory. So sit tight, guys. Be right back.